the problem with Tyler the Creator fans.
Oh, you look malnourished. Get some bread, fried an egg, yo, you're drowning in syrup.
Don't get me wrong, the dude can rap, but a lot of y'all are just saying he's the next this, he's the next that. His growth has been amazing. I just don't see it. So you have the album Goblin that was pretty well received for the underground at the time. Yeah, you know, some solid music, right? So you had Yonkers, obviously, which is the big one that everyone knows. It was definitely different at the time, but just nothing, at least in my eyes, that was just so out there. So you have the progression of all of his albums, then you finally get to Flower Boy, which in my opinion is definitely a step in the right direction. You can definitely tell he put a lot of time into the creative direction, from the cover art to the music videos to the collaborations. A good project, and in my opinion probably is his best one. Igor was a great album, but just didn't live up to what Flower Boy was. Then you have Igor coming in, that album you can definitely get lost in, you know, honestly, no pun intended, to his next album, Call Me If You Get Lost. You have the, you know, his biggest track, I think, to date is Earthquake, so with Playboi Carti, which was surprising in my opinion. You have that Playboi Carti feature, which just went over really well. His latest album, Call Me If You Get Lost, my favorites on there are What's Your Name with NBA Youngboy, and the intro, honestly forgot the name. As y'all can tell, I'm not too big of a Tyler fan, but I know y'all just go crazy for him. So Call Me If You Get Lost actually got nominated for a Grammy, and as a lot of you may know, it actually won Best Rap Album. That's what, is that back-to-back years, or was there a year in between? I mean, so honestly, if you think about it, I can understand why people are saying, oh, he's the next Kanye West, because that's a conversation I've been hearing a lot as well. It's gonna be a three-peat, just like Kanye's trilogy, right? So we'll just see how that goes over. I don't agree with him getting Grammys back to back. I can agree more so with Igor than Call Me If You Get Lost, because it was up against Donda, it was up against King's Disease 2. We know Drake pulled out. What other albums were there? Let me know in the comments what the other albums were. Just, I forgot, honestly. But over Donda is just, I don't see that. You have Jail, Hurricane. I mean, what else? Come to Life, literally a top 10 Kanye song. Top 10 Kanye song, all right? You have, what else? Lord, I Need You, Jesus Lord. Or, hold on, I'm tripping. Nah, I mean, Jesus Lord is good. Jesus Lord. You have Jesus Lord. A whole bunch of good songs. What? Anyway, I mean, that's just how I feel about Tyler. He's a good artist. His future is definitely up in the air. Like, I don't know, up in the air as far as like creative, because you know he's gonna have something nice. It's just you don't know what direction he's gonna go into. So we'll just see how it is with his next album. And he isn't a person that releases a lot of singles as well. That's what I've noticed with Tyler. Like, he really takes his time and it comes with like a complete body of work. So kudos to him for that. Y'all Tyler fans, y'all keep bugging me. Y'all want a review. Y'all want a ranking of his songs and all that. So I'll get that up on the channel soon. But that's it for me on this one. I just want to let y'all know, man, y'all Tyler fans, just cool it. Just cool it, all right? Just cool it a little bit. He's nice, but, you know, just, you know, he's not Kanye. He's not Drake, all right? So that's it for today, man. Just let me know what y'all think in the comments. All right, so that's it. I'm going to talk to y'all next time. Thank you for watching. Peace.